Good morning, my dear students. In this tutorial, we discuss properties of triangles, nothing but solution of triangles. The relation between the sides and angles in the triangle is called the properties of triangles. Look here. In this triangle, we discuss seven points. They are, first one, sine rule. Second, cosine rule. Third, projection rule. Fourth one, tangent rule or Napier's rule. Fifth one, half angle formulae. Sixth one, area of the triangle. Last but not least, that is Marwright's rule. These 7 points we discuss with detailed proof. Now, first one, that is sine rule. Sine rule is A by sine A equal to B by sine B equal to C by sine C. Here, A, B, C are the sides of the triangle. This was happened in triangle ABC. A is the side opposite to the angle A, B opposite to B, C opposite to C. Equal to 2R, that is equal to 2R. R is circumradius. We can easily prove this. Look carefully. There are two cases mainly in right: acute angle triangle, obtuse angle triangle, as well as right angle triangle. Also, we can prove it. Acute angle triangle ABC. ABC is a triangle. A vertex opposite is A. B vertex opposite is B. C vertex opposite side length C. It is angle A, angle B, angle C. Circumradius, the radius of the circle is called circumradius. This circle is called circumcircle. Now, this is the center. Join center and C, extend that. It cuts the circumference at D. Join B and D. This angle is A. These two angles are equal, are on the same segment, same chord. These two angles are equal. So this angle is angle A. This is the diameter. CD is diameter. Circumradius R. This is also R. It is a right angle triangle because CD is a diameter. It is angle in semicircle. It is a right angle triangle. So in right angle triangle, BDC, in triangle BDC, in triangle BDC, here sine A equal to A vertex opposite is BC, BC by hypotenuse CD, BC is A, hypotenuse, that is the diameter of the circle, 2R. Sine A equal to A by 2R. Sine A equal to A by 2R implies A by sine A equal to 2R. Similarly, B by sine B equal to 2R. C by sine C equal to 2R. Therefore, A by sine A equal to B by sine B equal to C by sine C equal to 2R. From this sine rule, we get A equal to, first one, A equal to 2R sine A, as well as B equal to 2R sine B, C equal to 2R sine C. Second, sine A equal to A by 2R, sine A equal to A by 2R, as well as sine B equal to B by 2R, sine C equal to C by 2R. So, if angle and opposite side, these two are given, we can find the radius, circumradius. Okay. Case 2. If the angle A is obtuse angle triangle, in before we discussed, that is case 1, that is A is acute angle triangle. In an acute angle triangle, if triangle ABC is obtuse angle triangle and obtuse angle is at A, in that case, case 2 it is obtuse angle triangle. So, circumcenter is this, join C and D, it is a circumcenter, it is D. Join B and D. Look here, these two are supplementary angles. These two are A, B, D, C are concyclic. These two are supplementary angles. That means D equal to 180 minus A. 180 minus A. Look here, it is the diameter of the circle. Diameter of the circle, it is center of the circle. Diameter of the circle. This angle is a right angle triangle, right angle. So here, sine 180 minus, in right angle triangle, sine 180 minus A equal to, sine 180 minus A equal to, opposite side is BC, BC by, that is a CD, hypotenuse is a CD, BC is A, it is A, CD is, it is circum diameter, that is 2R. Sin 180 minus A is sin A. Sin A equal to A by 2R. From this, A by 2R equal to, from this, A by sin A, so A by sin A equal to 2R. Similarly, B by sin B equal to 2R and C by sin C equal to 2R. Therefore, it was proved. Case 3. In a right angle triangle, it is the center of a circle, it is BC. A is any point on the semicircle, that is A is 90, sine A, sine A, look here, it is A, this is circumradius as well as that is the side A, A equal to 2R, that means 2R sine 90. Sin 90 is nothing but sin A, 2R sin A, A equal to 2R sin A. From this, A by sin A equal to 2R, A by sin A equal to 2R. Similarly, B by sin B equal to 2R, C by sin C equal to 2R. Therefore, sin rule is proved. Now, we are going to second point, that is cosine rule. Cosine rule is 1. A square equal to B square plus C square minus 2BC cos A, as well as B square equal to, second one, C square plus A square minus 2CA cos B, C square equal to A square plus B square minus 2AB cos C. Now, in triangle ABC, draw perpendicular from A to side BC, triangle ABC, perpendicular drawn from A to BC, that is BD. This is angle A, this is angle B, this is the side A, vertex opposite to A, this is B and this is C. This is angle B and this is angle C. In this right angle triangle ADC, look carefully, in this right angle triangle ADC, sin C equal to AD by B. So, AD equal to B sin C. This is B sin C. In this, the same triangle ADC, cos C equal to adjacent by hypotenuse, CD by B. CD equal to B cos C. This is B cos C. Look here. Total length is A. This is A. So it is A. So A minus B cos C. Now it is a right angle triangle. By applying Pythagoras theorem, C square equal to A minus B cos C whole square plus B sin C whole square. Now expand this. Simply we get that. Simply we get that is equal to a square minus 2ab cos c plus b square cos square c plus b square sin square c. Okay, by adding these two, that means taking common b square, cos square c plus sin square c, that is 1. So c square equal to a square. From these two addition, we get b square minus 2ab cos c. That happens c square equal to a square plus b square minus 2ab cos c. Similarly, b square equal to this and a square equal to this. We can easily do this. From this, look here. In the triangle, two sides are given and including angle is given. We can find the third side. Two sides and including angle C, these two are given, then we can find the third side C square. As well as, if three sides are given, then we can find the angles. For example, cos from this relation, cos A equal to yes, B square plus C square minus A square by 2BC. So, if sides are given, then we can find the angles of the triangle. So, cosine rule is proved. Now we discuss projection rule 1. A equal to B cos C plus C cos B. B equal to C cos A plus A cos C. As well as third one, similarly, C equal to A cos B plus B cos C. In triangle ABC, draw perpendicular from A to the side BC. It is angle A, it is angle B. It is a right angle triangle. ADB is a right angle triangle. From this, cos B equal to BD by AB. BD by AB means, that is C. AB is C, AC is B, BC is A. BC is A, this is length A. BD by, that is C. Cos B. BD equal to, from this relation, BD equal to C cos B. Now, in the triangle ADC, in this right angle triangle, cos C equal to CD by AC. CD is adjacent, AC is hypotenuse. That is equal to CD by AC is B, that is cos C. By cross multiplication, CD equal to B cos C. But here, you observe that A equal to BC, A is equal to BC, that is nothing but BD plus CD or DC. BD is C cos B plus B cos C. So that is equal to C cos B plus B cos C. That is A. Therefore, A equal to B cos C plus C cos B. Similarly, we can easily prove that. Look here, my students, here A acute or obtuse, no change in that. In case of right angle triangle, that is true. Okay. Now, we discuss tangent rule, first one. Tan A minus B by 2 equal to A minus B by A plus B into cot C by 2. Second one, tan B minus C by 2 equal to B minus C by B plus C into cot A by 2. Third one, tan C minus A by 2 equal to C minus A by C plus A into cot B by 2. Now, we are going to the proof of the first one. That is, further consider A minus B by A plus B. So, A equal from sine rule, A equal to 2R sine A, B equal to 2R sine B. Taking common 2R, we get 2R into sine A minus sine B by sine A, 2R into sine A plus sine B. Now here, 2R cancel both sides, up and down cancel. Sine A minus sine B transformations, that is 2 cos A plus B by 2 by 2 cos A plus B by 2 into sine A minus B by 2 by 2 sine, sine A plus sine B, 2 sine A plus B by 2 into sine A minus B by 2 into cos, cos A minus B by 2, cos A minus B by 2. Now here, this is 2 to cancel, cos by sine, that is cot A plus B by 2 into, this is tan A minus B by 2. Tan A minus B by 2. Cot A plus B by 2, that is nothing but A plus B by 2 can be written as, that is 90 minus C by 2. Cot 90 minus C by 2, that is tan C by 2 into tan A minus B by 2. This is the value of A minus B by A plus B. So, tan A minus B by 2, this tan C by 2, take this side, that become reciprocal of that is cot C by 2. So, tan A minus B by 2, tan A minus B by 2 equal to A minus B by A plus B into tan C by 2, take that side, that become cot C by 2. Similarly, we can easily prove the remaining two. Now we discuss fifth one, half angle formula. First one, sine A by 2 equal to square root of S minus B into S minus C by BC, where S is semi-perimeter, that means A plus B plus C by 2, A plus B plus C is perimeter, half of that is S. S sine A by 2. Similarly, you can write sine B by 2 and sine C by 2. Second, cos A by 2, that is root of S into S minus A by BC. From these two, by using these two, tan A by 2 equal to sine A by 2 by cos A by 2, BC, BC cancel, we get square root of S minus B into S minus C by S into S minus A. This can be also written as numerator and denominator multiply with S into S minus A, that become delta by S into S minus A. If you write S minus numerator and denominator multiply with S minus B into S minus C, we can write that as S minus B into S minus C by delta. So, depending on the problem, we can use any one of the formula. We need to delta in denominator, you have to use this. We need to delta in numerator, you have to use this. That's why you can write any one formula depending on the situation of the problem. Now, how to prove this? How to prove this? Simple, very simple. You know, from cosine rule, you know cos A formula. Cos A. Cos A equal to B square plus C square minus A square by 2BC. The proof is left for you. Just I give the hint to that. Cos A. Cos A, we have a formula. We have cos A equal to 2 sine square A by 2 minus 1. That is also same as 1 minus 2 cos square. 2 cos square. So by using this formula, cosine rule, cos A equal to this. Cos A, we have a formula, that is cos square A by 2 minus sin square A by 2. That is also written as 2 cos square A by 2 minus 1. That is same as 1 minus 2 sin square root A by 2. That means sin A by 2 that equal root of 1 minus cos A by 2. You have to use cos A formula here. By using cos A formula, substitute here and simplifying, we get this. Now we discuss the sixth point, that is area of the triangle. In triangle ABC, area of the triangle is denoted by delta. 1. Delta equal to half BC sin A. In the same way, half AB, half BC sin A, half CA sin B, half AB sin C. We can easily prove this. Next, another, that is ABC by 4R. Third one, delta equal to 2R square sin A sin B sin C. Last one, you know this formula, Huron's formula, delta equal to root of S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. If the triangle sides are given, we can find the area of the triangle by using this formula you learn in lower class. Now we go to the proof of this first one, that is very simple proof. If you know the proof, then you can easily remember the formula. In triangle ABC, draw perpendicular from A to the side BC, that is AD. This is the side A. This is angle. This is angle C. This is A. In triangle ADC, in triangle ADC, this is side C. Sine C equal to opposite, that is AD, by hypotenuse AC. Hypotenuse AC is opposite the vertex B, that is B. AD by B. So AD equal to B sin C. In projection rule and cosine rule, we know that AD equal to B sin C. That is height of the triangle. That is height of the triangle. So area of the triangle, basic formula is half into base into height. Base is A. Height is B sin C. So area of the triangle is half AB sin C. Similarly, you can prove the remaining. Second one, that is half AB sin C, that is half into sin C can be written as C by 2R, from sin rule, C by 2R, that equal to ABC by 4R, that is delta. Third one, we can prove that by using sin rule, A equal to delta equal to ABC by 4R, we know that, we have proved that A equal to 2R sin A, B equal to 2R sin B, C equal to 2R sin C by 4R. 2R, 2 cancel. 2 into R into 2, 4R, 4R, 4 cancel. That equal to 2R square sin A, sin B, sin C. That is third one. Fourth one, you know very well about that. Fourth one, you know that. Seventh one, Marwick's rule, A plus B by C equal to sin A minus cos A minus B by 2 by sin C by 2. A minus B by C equal to sin A minus B by 2 by cos C by 2. By using these two, you can prove tangent rule also. Division of these two, second by one, we get tangent rule. So how to prove this? In tangent rule, we prove that A equal to 2R sin A, B equal to 2R sin C, 2R common, cancel that, and using transformations, we get easily this one. Okay. Thank you, my dear students. Bye.